Welcome, everyone. My name is Dr. Dan, and welcome to our part one of three series for your timeline to succeed in love. And tonight is going to be incredible in terms of the amount of information that we're going to cover. But again, it's all about, we're going to deal all about relationship trauma. Again, my name is Dr. Dan. I'm a cognitive behavior psychotherapist. I'm here with Yanni. She's my co-host, and she will also share her I would say experience and a lot of her tips in terms of how to go over this trauma. I've been dealing a lot with marital counseling. I do dissociative identity disorder. I do anger management. So if anyone here have any anger problem, let me know. I deal a lot with NPD, which is narcissistic personality disorder. And we will cover that a lot tonight as well, because these are also a part of relationship traumas. People who are NPD, and those actually who are connected emotionally with someone who's narcissistic.
Traumatic stress disorder. And,
have anyone heard about post-traumatic relationship syndrome? PTRS. No? Okay. It acts the same, because PTSD, most people relate PTSD to veterans, those who've been in the army, those who've been seeing a lot of like traumatic events, such as like people.
Yes, Dan, you're associating somebody who has a breakup with somebody.
I will explain. Mentally versus physically. But hold on.
Kill other people and witnesses.
It does exactly the same effect in the brain when it, whatever it leaves in terms of effect. Okay, Adam, people, whatever they see, like childhood trauma can leave PTSD. Or the army, the veterans can leave with PTSD. Any kind of effect that is really traumatic will leave.
Abuse.
Abuse, yeah. Sexual abuse, emotional abuse, toxic abuse, whatever it is, it will still leave the same effect. For the brain, from the bottom of your heart, and that person cheats or abuse you emotionally and all that, it will leave a traumatic experience. Just exactly, or maybe not to a point of people dying in front of them, but the effect is still there. And you will still have, in the future, you will drag this kind of effect.
In life with false beliefs. And there's a very simple belief that's going to help you going forward. And that belief is that everyone is different. And you're the one to choose not to be chosen. So choose someone that is different and makes you feel different.
You'll have in the future, you will drag this kind of effect into the future with your relationships. So it will still leave you a bad, sour taste in your mouth. And you will never trust any woman. You're always going to think that the future woman is going to act like the past woman. And that's why this whole idea of this seminar, and why did we say your timeline to succeed in love, is because people take everything from the past, they bring it to the present, and they drag it into the future.
So use it to learn what you need in your life to be happy and what you don't want to tolerate. Who is the person that you're looking for that will have the capacity to make you happy? Because everyone is different. Some people like things a certain way, some others like something a different way. And we already know that we can't change people. So have clear your do's and don'ts, embrace your traumas, understand that life is about challenges, and those that shake us will cause traumas.
A lot of people are now, they don't know how to date anymore. The whole dating scene has completely changed, and that created a lot of isolation, mind isolation, where people just don't know who they could talk to, who they could have interaction. This is why Zoom is doing so well, because the virtual interaction that helps people keep somewhat of a mental stability, or else everyone will be going crazy. But the thing is, drag the negative past into the present or into the future. This is what we call the relationship, besides relationship trauma, but relationship esteem. Do you know where the word esteem come from?
I couldn't hear you.
Do you know where the word esteem come from?
Esteem?
The origination word of esteem. Anyone?
Go ahead, Dan. I don't know the origin.
Okay.
Word.
Esteem.
I have Google, so I can look it up.
It's a Greek word. Its word is estimate. You estimate yourself, and there's no self-esteem. I'd like to tell everyone the word self-esteem does not exist. It's them esteem, which means you let other people esteem you.
I do have a recommendation for Emily. Emily, we should always make assessments. You can take a piece of paper and you can write all the things that you remember in all those dates that made you say no, goodbye. You have to revise the list of red flags because you don't want to become too much of a hypervigilant. Remember, we're not perfect and you're not perfect either. No one is perfect. The men that you will spend the rest of your life with, once you find the one, will not be perfect. So you have to be careful on the things that don't matter much. Like, which are the things that will make you, that will make me really unhappy? Which are the things that will evolve into bigger things and I would definitely not be able to live with? So revise your list in case there are some of those red flags that are not so important and might be your break at the moment. Those are your breaks are too sensitive because you don't want to be your own enemy. How old are you?
Happiness is from within. A lot of people you've heard, is happiness a choice or is it a feeling? Do you feel happy or do you choose to be happy? Okay, so the same goes with relationship, Babak. The thing is that, like Yanni said, you choose your partner choose you. The rest is really up to you to make yourself happy. No one is gonna make you happy if you're not happy from within. You're gonna have to really work on yourself. All the session has been recorded. So I'm gonna send, once Yanni and I are going to upload it on YouTube and after editing it, we will send you a copy. And you're also gonna receive the dates for next session, or I would say next seminar. And we will cover topics such as comparison, which Mike, you told me that you always love to compare yourself with others.
Don't, please, don't.
Yes, we're gonna talk about also, what did we discuss about, Yanni?
My mind. Oh my God, this is getting late.
Yes, it is getting late, yes. I'm getting older. But everything that has to do, again, the same common core, which is the relationship trauma, and also how you accuse, like accusation, how you accuse other people of your misbehavior, of what you've done and what you expect to do in future relationship. So you're always gonna say, it's because of her that I became like that. It's because of him that I became this way. No, it's because of yourself. If you give the power to someone else to treat you badly, it's all on you. Okay? You're gonna meet a lot of nasty people out there. That's a given. And this is something that you have to be aware of. Don't be naive. You're gonna have to take action. You're gonna have to really take initiative to not let anyone take advantage of you any time in your life.
Dan, are you suggesting that we have to take responsibility for ourselves?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Not. Oh, darn it. That's discouraging.
Yes. Yes. Like I said, we're the bearer of bad news, huh? And this is bad news to take responsibility for your own action and for your own life. But overall, I would say, you guys, I hope that you all learned a lot of information tonight. And our goal, Yanni and I, is to be able to bring a lot more to the table so everyone do not make the same mistake again. And that's why we decided to do this seminar. Is going back into the future or back into the past with a DeLorean. And you all now know how things happen, how to avoid them, and how to move forward without taking any bad negative experience into the present relationship. Because everything in life is about the present. No one can guarantee the future and no one can change the past.